Okay, so what we want to show, sometimes the chains that come on these are way too tight. They're what they used to call ribbon tight. This one is not ribbon tight. It's so tight you can't wobble it. This one you can wobble a little bit, but it's not enough. In our opinion, we need to loosen a little bit. This is the engine sprocket, and too tight of a chain will wear out your engine sprocket and will also wear out your chain. Well, not so much your back sprocket. So what we do is to adjust the chain, we loosen these four bolts first. Heads up, we loosen the bolts a little bit before we showed the video because these generally come extremely tight. We didn't want to waste your time showing how to do it by just doing tight bolts. So we're going, this in here is a number 12. The nut is number 12. The head of the bolt is a number 10. So we're just going to get these loosened here first. You do not have to remove the bolts at all. You just have to loosen it. Then we're going to do the same on the other side. We're going to get these loosened. Okay, so you can see that I've got those loosened. And then we're going to do that on the same here, get these loosened, and we'll come back and show you how to adjust the chain. So we've finished loosening these four bolts and nuts. Now what we want to do, it does not take much. I'm going to go about a quarter of a turn on both of them at the same amount, because then it will keep the axle level. Okay, see, that is a much better slack in the chain. It's not as tight. I'm just going to go just a tad bit more, about a maybe a 16th of a turn. This one's just like that. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back. What I am going to do, just to double check, if I have a level, you can do that, but I'm just going to make sure that the axle is straight. Actually, axle's a little off, so I'm going to tighten this one up here a little bit. And then I'm going to check my chain. Oh, yeah, that's right there, that's perfect slack. You can go up and down with that. Okay, so now I'm going to tighten these four back up, and I'm going to do it evenly. So I'm going to do this one here, then that one, and then I'll do the top ones going back and forth, kind of like putting on a tire crisscross. So I'm going to tighten this one first, then this one, then go up here and go up there. That way I keep that axle uniform. Also, as you can see, because I did these first four and then this, I was able to keep the engine sprocket and chain sprocket, the rear axle sprocket, in line. Okay, so I got the bottom tightened. When you do tighten the bolt and nut, I always like to use this inner wrench because it's less likely for you to slip and round the heads on the bolts, which I've seen some customers do. So I have this one nice and tight. Now we're going to do the same on the other side. Again, I'm using, if you want to use the open end while you're tightening it, that's okay. But when you go and do the final snug down, you're going want to take your open, and again that's 12 and the heads are 10. So again, we got this is a nice slack, a lot better than what it was before, and that's how you adjust your chain correctly, keep the axle level and the chain lined up to the sprocket. Once you get the proper tightness with the chain, you're going to want to use a good chain lube, not this crappy stuff out on the market, but a good chain lube. We sell the Lucas. The reason we sell the Lucas is it lubricates and it adheres to the chain and doesn't collect all the dust and the dirt and the stuff like that. So it extends chain life and it also extends the sprocket life. And it most of our customers go with the premium kit, and when you go with the premium kit, you get a can of the Lucas chain lube for free.